When it comes to something as life and death important as to what to feed ourselves and our families, we should rely not on anecdotes, but on facts. Welcome to the Nutrition Facts Podcast. I'm your host, Dr. Michael Greger. Have you ever heard of the Trendelenburg position? Lying in this position at a slight head-down tilt may actually help you burn fat. Here's the first story. When our blood volume drops, our kidneys detect it and angiotensin is released. When our blood volume rises, on the other hand, our heart detects it and releases a hormone called AMP, atrial natriuretic peptide, also known as ANF, atrial natriuretic factor. We used to think our heart was just a pump, but now we know it's also a gland. There are stretch receptors in the first chamber of our heart. And when extra blood pours into the heart, ANP is released. What does it do? As the title of a review in a obesity journal put it, heart hormones fuel a fire in fat. If you drip ANP on human fat and muscle tissue, fat is rapidly released and the muscle cells ramp up their capacity to burn it. Infuse ANP into people, and the rate at which fat is mobilized and burned can shoot up 15%. You can take muscle biopsies from people and show how much better their muscles get at burning fat in the presence of elevated AMP levels. No surprise, then, that obese and overweight individuals tend to have considerably lower levels in their bloodstream, so the way to a person's stomach may be through their heart. Why would this stretch-sensitive heart hormone tap into our fat stores? Well, when does the heart get stretched? During intense physical activity. We used to think it was just the adrenaline-type hormones that are released when you exercise that mobilize fat from our tissues, but now we know that ANP from our heart plays a key role as well. Inject people with the amount of ANP they'd normally get in their system when exercising, and their whole body fat burning goes up, even if they're just sitting on the couch. How else can we stretch our heart that extra little bit to release ANP? By increasing our blood volume by drinking extra water. When you don't drink for 12 hours straight, your AMP levels in your blood fall by about 25%, but chug down about 4 glasses of water and your levels can jump up by 50% within 90 minutes. Now, that's too much to drink at one time, but it can offer a sense of how much potential control we have over this fat-burning hormone. How else could we trick our body into producing this exercise hormone without lacing up our gym shoes? If it's all about pooling extra blood into our heart, what about lying with our head tilted down? Sounds kind of funny, but researchers took the possibility seriously enough to run the experiment. They laid people down at just a 6-degree angle, a slight tilt. That's like putting 3 or 4 bricks under the posts at the foot of your bed, so it's not like you're hanging upside down. They were almost flat, but at just enough of a slant for gravity to draw extra blood into their torso. Within an hour, their AMP levels doubled and stayed up for the 4 hours the experiment ran. Okay, but did they all of a sudden start burning more fat? Yes. The proportion of fat they were burning as fuel shot up by 40%, and they were just lying down the whole time. So what if you tried sleeping with a slight head-down tilt by putting a few bricks under the posts at the foot of your bed? Would it cause you to burn more fat while you slept? I'll address the potential pros and cons next. In my last video, I noted how lying at a slight 6-degree head-down tilt for a few hours can boost fat burning. Now, obviously, you wouldn't want to lie tilted back if you had a heart condition, such as congestive heart failure. As many as 8 to 12 cups of blood may be displaced into the torso from the extremities at a tilt like that, so you have to have the cardiovascular fitness to handle it. Acid reflux could also be a problem. In fact, we typically tell heartburn patients to do the reverse. Put a few bricks under the posts at the head of their bed to have gravity work in their favor to keep stomach acid down where it belongs. But for those without medical problems, is there a harm to lying tilted back for a few hours? Well, it could give you a space headache. In movies, astronauts are shown practicing underwater, but the gold standard for simulating the physiological effects of the weightlessness of outer space is HDBR, head-down bed rest. On Earth, our blood tends to collect in our legs, so our body is designed to force blood headward. In outer space,
our body's still trying to push our blood up, so without Earth's gravity, blood pushes upwards to our head and chest, just like it does when we lie tilted back. And this realization came from cosmonauts returning from the space station, feeling as though they were slipping towards the foot of the bed and only feeling quote-unquote normal when they were tilted 6 degrees back. All the extra blood pooling in the head is thought to contribute to the headaches reported by up to 70% of astronauts during space flights, and a similar percentage of individuals suffer headaches from prolonged head-down bed rest. That's after days, though. In preparation for a mission to Mars, space agencies put people through head-down bed rest for prolonged periods, eating, bathing, and toileting, all while lying in bed tilted back for literally months at a time. Extended stretches of head-down positioning for weeks may impair lung function, brain function, and immune function, and cause a loss of muscle mass. On the last Apollo mission, the astronauts lost about 5 pounds of fat over the 12-day trip, but they also lost about 2 pounds of lean body mass. Prolonged weightlessness or bed rest, regardless of tilt, can result in muscle and bone loss, but just sleeping on a slant by putting a few bricks under the post at the foot of your bed could potentially give you a boost in fat metabolism without the long-term adverse effects. If you want to try it, a note of caution. Take it slow when standing back up. After just 4 hours of a 6-degree head-down tilt, most people experience reduced orthostatic tolerance. When anyone stands suddenly after sitting or lying down for a while, you can get a head rush, feel dizzy, faint, or lightheaded as the blood drains from your brain down into your legs before your body can compensate. This can be exacerbated by lying with your head tilted back, so be careful, get up gradually. Drinking 2 cups of cold water 30 minutes before rising may also help. Do not try this at home if you have any heart or lung issues or problems with your brain, like head trauma or eyes. Even a family history of glaucoma disqualifies you. Ask your physician if they think it's safe for you to sleep in quote-unquote mild Trendelenburg. Friedrich Trendelenburg was a pioneering surgeon that popularized the use of what was formerly referred to as head-down position for certain abdominal and pelvic procedures, angling the operating table back 15 to 30 degrees, pulls some abdominal organs out of the way to help declutter the surgical field, resulting in what is now widely known as the Trendelenburg position. Steep Trendelenburg, like 25-30 degree tilt, has been associated with transient visual problems thought due to the increase in pressure within the eyeball. Cautions have been issued for those at risk for glaucoma, a disease of increased eye pressure, to avoid inversion therapy, where people hang upside down, as well as yoga positions like handstands, which can have a similar effect. Lying back in mild Trendelenburg, like around 6 degrees, can cause a fleeting bump in eye pressure that appears to normalize within a few hours, but the pooling of blood in the head may reduce blood flow to the retina, sufficient to impair nerve impulses. Similar effects have been noted within the brain. Intracranial pressure also normalizes after a few hours at a 6-degree head-down tilt, but the overall blood flow through the brain does drop a bit. This is why you shouldn't try this if you have eye or brain pathology. To my surprise, sleeping in mild Trendelenburg was actually put to the test to prevent bone loss in sedentary individuals. Restrict people's activity to walking less than 2 miles a day on average, and within a year, they can lose as much as 15% of their bone mineral density. What happened to those randomized to the same exercise restriction, but also combined with sleeping at a 2-degree head-down tilt that was increased by 2 degrees about every 2 months, so they ended up sleeping at a 14-degree slant, or whatever angle they felt comfortable with, by the end of the year? Not only did it completely block the bone loss, they built more bone. Despite the movement restriction, they ended up with about 12% greater bone mineral density than when they started. Note that this bone-building effect was only apparent in sedentary individuals. Another group randomized to the same mild Trendelenburg, but assigned to run an average of 5 or 6 miles a day, just maintained their same skeletal integrity. The study was repeated, and the same remarkable effects were found. There's something about the periodic fluid redistribution that comes with sleeping tilted back at night that actively builds both bone density and volume after the day-long stagnant pooling of blood in the legs of sedentary individuals. The research team claims that this is just the beginning to the benefits, citing quote-unquote unpublished studies asserting a near panacea of perk to sleeping in Trendelenburg. I can't be too critical of this apparent dodge when I can't point to a single study supporting my supposition that it'll help with weight loss. As far as I can tell, it's never been tried or even proposed. What I can promise is that any researchers who take on the mantle of putting it to the test will definitely have their study featured in a video on NutritionFacts.org.
We would love it if you could share with us your stories about reinventing your health through evidence-based nutrition. Go to NutritionFacts.org/testimonials, and we may share it on our social media to help inspire others. If you see any graphs, charts, graphics, images, or studies mentioned here, please go to the Nutrition Facts podcast landing page. There you'll find all the detailed information you need, plus links to all the sources we cite for each of these topics. My latest major book, How Not to Age, is out. Check it out from your local public library. And of course, all proceeds from the sale of all my books go to charity. I actually just came out with another small book, an easy 100-page read on Ozempic and other GLP-1 drugs. Go to NutritionFacts.org and click on Books to see where you can get an ebook, audiobook, or paperback of it. NutritionFacts.org is a nonprofit science-based public service where you can sign up for free daily updates on the latest in nutrition research with bite-sized videos and articles. Everything on the website is free. There are no ads, no corporate sponsorships, no kickbacks, strictly non-commercial, not selling anything. Just put it up as a public service, as a labor of love, as a tribute to my grandmother, whose own life was saved with evidence-based nutrition.